There is no limit to how much you want. Even $100 trillion is not enough. Because once you have the entire planet, you would want to go to Mars. You perfectly know who I am talking about. On the other side, the good news is that once these people leave the Earth, they will no longer be on the Forbes list, because the Forbes list considers people who live here on Earth, which means now you have a higher chance to be on the top of the Forbes list. But I think the founder of LVMH, Bernard Arnault, will take their position, because apparently it seems like you don't need to build a tech company to become world's richest person. All you have to do is sell overpriced handbags to people who make a lot of money but are still dumb enough to waste all that money on overpriced handbags with a logo that literally says, "I have paid $5,000 for this handbag that literally performs the exact same job that any other handbag does, that cost $10. But you can't call them dumb because they're making so much money. But they could be dumb because they're wasting that money on dumb things. So I will leave that question for you to answer in the comment section. I did not mean to offend anyone. I just can't understand why anyone would pay $5,000 or $10,000 for a handbag. Maybe I'm just not smart enough to understand that. Let's get back to the question of this video. How much money do you need to retire? Let's just be realistic. $10 million? $100 million? $1 billion? The answer is far from that. In order to answer that question, we have to take a look at a few statistics. In 2019, right before the pandemic, the Bureau of Labor Statistics said that the median personal income is $36,000 or $61,000 for households. But let's ignore the median and focus on the average household income, which is $88,000. Of course, this number is not accurate for everyone, because if you are in your 20s, you need far less money compared to someone who is in their 60s who needs to pay a fortune on insurance, because with age comes health problems. That's why if you want to save money, take care of your health and stop eating all that junk food. The next question is, how much do you need to invest in order to earn $87,864 every single year without doing anything? We're going to take a look at a few available options and we will do the math. If that number is higher or lower for you, you can just take that equation and use a different number that suits your circumstances more accurately. Don't be scared of the numbers we'll talk about, because at the end of the video, it will all make sense. That's why it's important to pay attention. I get it, it's not easy. After watching 15 seconds TikTok videos, watching a 10-minute YouTube video seems like a 3-hour movie. But I promise, the value you will get from this video is far more than you will get from browsing TikTok for hours. But before we get into that, let's thank the sponsor of this video, Kaspersky Privacy Checker. Nowadays, almost everything we do is somehow connected to the internet, from how we work to how we interact with friends and family. But our personal data became more vulnerable. Many companies either discreetly or openly collect information about us to use or sell by showing us an ad that we're likely to click on. But what if your data lands in the wrong hands? I personally had once my Instagram account hacked where inappropriate messages have been sent to my friends. But what if my personal data was used to hack my bank account? They would have had my name, my address, and even my zip code. Such vulnerability makes you an easy target for scammers who may try and use any of your information to hack your investing or even trusting fund account. No one is safe from such exposure, and that's why you need Kaspersky Privacy Checker. Here's how it works. Choose the level of privacy you're comfortable with, a platform, and the website or an app you're interested in. The Privacy Checker will give you all the needed instructions to keep your account from getting hacked, how to keep Instagram from monitoring you, how to defeat spammers and trolls, and most importantly, how to clean up other traces of your presence. Follow the link in the description to learn more from Kaspersky on how to keep your personal information to yourself for free. And now, let's get back to the video. Have you heard the phrase, never spend the principal, only spend the interest? And that's the key to financial freedom. If you have inherited $10 million, let's say you invested and get a 5% interest annually, that's $500,000 a year. For the rest of your life, you could constantly spend $500,000 or $41,606 every single month for the rest of your life, and your wealth won't even decrease by a single penny. That's way better than splashing $10 million in one single night. But the key question is, since the average household income is $87,864, how much do you need to invest to make that much money every single year? For the sake of this example, we're not going to take any risky investments such as crypto or individual stocks such as Tesla or GameStop. We are going to be ultra conservative and take something super stable, something that historically has proven to grow by a decent percent, like the S&P 500 that grows by around 10% a year. 10% out of $878,640 is $87,864, the amount we're looking for. This means if you manage to invest $878,000 for the rest of your life, you can spend $87,000 and your wealth will remain the same. But the problem is that, how do you save $878,640 when the average household income is $88,000? That's literally saving every single penny you earn for 10 straight years, which is impossible for most people. And that's the average, which means most people who are in their 20s do not make anything close to that. And that's where the magic of compound interest comes into the picture. Let's say you are 21 years old, you're about to graduate and looking for a job, but luckily you have saved $1,000. Whether you partied less, avoided cool Starbucks coffees, or you were single during your college days. That's one of the benefits of being single. But is it worth it? Anyways, let's assume you will invest that amount into the S&P 500 and completely forget about it. You're not going to withdraw it the next September when the new iPhone comes up or when you have no money left to hang out with your friends. You will live as if you have never had that money in the first place. And every single year, till the time you retire, you commit to invest $1,000 into the S&P 500. When you retire at 66, you will end up with $863,685 or $86,368 every single year. By saving just $1,000 a year, you have built wealth that's worth almost $1 million and generates $86,000 a year. That's why Einstein once said, "Compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world. He who understands it, earns it. He who doesn't, pays it." I know that waiting for 45 years sounds like a really, really long time, but we also took a very small amount of money. Saving $1,000 is not a big deal for most of the people who are watching this video. We can take a more extreme example where you could save $3,000 or $5,000 and you won't have to wait for 45 years to reap the rewards of compound interest. Let me know in the comment section below, how much are you willing to invest a year? But not everything is sunshine and rainbows. While in theory it's possible to get a 10% rate of return, in practice it gets slightly more complicated. The inflation rate in the US is around 2-3%, which means if you don't want the real value of your investment to decrease every single year by 2-3%, you should not withdraw more than 7% of your investments. On top of it, if you want your investment to grow by at least a small margin, like 2%, you're left with just 5%. So, if you want to be able to withdraw $87,000 every single year and be confident that inflation won't wipe away your wealth over time, you have to invest double that amount, or $1.7 million, or $2,000 every single year instead of $1,000. Which is still reasonable for most people. If you check out the FIRE community on the internet, you will find out endless examples of people lived frugally for 5, 10, or 15 years and saved the vast majority of their earnings, but eventually became financially independent. You don't have to go that extreme because life without work is boring, so you can pursue this strategy as a backup plan in case if things go south. But you probably have a million questions about how is that possible. I get it. I was once in your position, and to answer all of your questions, I have created a course that's simple, straightforward, and fully animated. I've literally answered almost all of the questions you have in your mind. I strongly recommend it if you're serious about investing. It will not just teach you how to invest in index funds, but teach you also how to analyze stocks, how to read financial statements, and at the end of the course, you will have to complete an assignment that I will personally check. And the best part of it is that you can get 2 weeks of Skillshare Premium if you use the link in the description and get the course for free. So don't miss it. But what you also have to keep in mind is that you should not do anything with your money unless you have covered your credit card debts first. If your credit card has an annual percentage rate of, let's say, 20%, that doesn't mean you get charged 20% interest once a year, depending on how you manage your account. That's because interest is calculated on a daily basis, not annually, and it's charged only if you carry debt from month to month. So it doesn't make sense to aim for a 10% rate of return while you have a debt with a 20% interest. And now it's time to give this video a thumbs up, and if you have enjoyed it, you will most definitely enjoy this custom playlist that I have created specifically for you that has our most popular videos on investing, stock market, and personal finance that could potentially change your life. And if you're new around here, make sure to subscribe and turn on your notifications. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.